So there is a massive pandemic brewing. In fact, it's already affecting over 80% of the population in Southeast Asia and is growing worldwide at an accelerated rate. And this is projected to affect over 58% of the population here in the US in just the next generation. And unfortunately, this pandemic can rob you of your most precious sense, your eyesight, and is estimated to contribute up to 43% of all permanent, uncorrectable sources of vision loss here in the US in just the upcoming years. This is known as the myopia pandemic. And if you've never heard of the word myopia before, it is the medical term for nearsightedness. The fact is, the human population is becoming increasingly more and more nearsighted over time. And unfortunately, this is linked to higher rates of eye and vision issues, including those that often lead to blindness. Now, chances are you yourself, or maybe a family member of yours, is already nearsighted. Like myself, I've worn high prescription glasses as well as contact lenses to correct for my nearsightedness since I was young. But for those of you who aren't nearsighted, myopia is where people experience blurred or out-of-focus vision looking far away in the distance, but they still are able to see pretty well up close at near. Now, truthfully, while growing up, I never really thought much about this. I just went and got new prescriptions for glasses and contact lenses, and they helped me see better. But it wasn't until I went to optometry school and became an eye doctor did I start to better understand why this was all happening in the first place and the potential serious consequences of becoming increasingly more and more nearsighted. So here is the issue. With myopia, as somebody grows up, the eyeball doesn't just become stronger, requiring a higher need for a glasses prescription. The eyeball indeed grows longer. Literally, the eyeball begins to stretch out, going deeper into the orbits, closer to the brain. And with this growth, three things begin to happen. First of which, most of us notice and experience, and that's that our eyesight gets worse. This is because the light is no longer focusing on the back of the eyeball. Instead, light is now focused too far forward in front of the retina. And that's where glasses, contact lenses, and some refractive surgery procedures like LASIK come in. They essentially just move that focusing point a little bit further back so it's landing on the back of the eyeball again. Which thankfully does give us clearer eyesight again, at least for a time. Until, of course, the eyeball grows a little bit longer again, requiring stronger and stronger need for glasses. But as the eyeball continues to grow and stretch, that's where some more serious problems begin to arise. Imagine blowing up a balloon. If you inflate that balloon too much, eventually the rubber will stretch out and grow thin, eventually bursting the balloon. And in a way, this is basically what can happen to the delicate retinal tissues in the back of the eye. The retina is the delicate neural tissue, the extension of our brain that gives us our ability for eyesight. And unfortunately, as the eyeball grows with myopia, the retinal tissue does not necessarily grow with it. Instead, it begins to stretch out and grow thin, much like that balloon I mentioned. When stretched, the retina in the back of the eye begin to separate from the gel inside of the eye that we call the vitreous humor. This is why people with nearsightedness tend to develop eye floaters at a younger age. And with that separation of the gel, there's also a reduction in antioxidants and metabolites that can reach the lens inside of the eye, and is one of the theories of why people with myopia tend to develop a much higher rate of cataract formation. Furthermore, as this gel begins to separate from the retina, the gel can tug on the retina a little bit, creating holes and tears, which allows fluid inside of the eye to seep behind the retina, creating what is called a retinal detachment, which is a true ocular emergency, and if it's not caught and treated appropriately in an urgent fashion, can lead to permanent blindness and vision loss. Another thing that can happen is that as the retina begins to stretch out, it becomes thin and stops functioning the same way. And with higher degrees of myopia and with age, this can lead to reduction in eyesight that cannot be corrected with glasses, contact lenses, or any eye surgeries. And we call this myopic maculopathy. And then in some extreme cases, the retina can stretch out and become so thin, it begins to crack open in what we call Lacquer cracks. And this is where new blood vessels may be able to leak inside of the eye, causing bleeding, leading to further damage and vision loss. Now, I know all of this so far can sound pretty overwhelming, but there is one more thing that can happen as myopia progresses. As the eyeball continues to grow deeper into the orbit, the nerve, the optic nerve that connects the eyeball to the brain, can also get pushed further back. And this causes the nerve to become kinked off in a way. And we can even see this on MRI scans. And with this, there's believed to be reduced blood flow and nutrients getting to the nerve, which causes it to not be as healthy. And this is one of the reasons we believe that people with myopia have a much higher risk of developing glaucoma, which is a condition where the nerve slowly dies over time, leading to permanent vision loss if not caught early. Now, I know hearing all of this may sound really alarming, and this video may come off a bit dramatic, but honestly, I did this on purpose because this is such a serious issue as it pertains to our eye health and vision. And when you think about young kids and how myopia can affect them, it becomes a real concern. And I know that a lot of parents and a lot of other healthcare professionals outside of eye care may not fully understand or grasp the seriousness of nearsightedness and myopia. And so from here, I'm sure you have two major questions. First is why? Why is myopia becoming more frequent and to such greater degree? And then two, is there anything we can do about it? Are there ways to slow down or stop myopia? And the good news is yes, there are scientific and clinical ways that we can now slow down myopia from progressing. And so the next few videos in this video series will first cover why myopia is progressing at such an alarming rate, as well as sharing tips of lifestyle things that you and your family can start incorporating right now to slow down or reduce the risk of myopia. And then in the last video, we'll cover all of the different clinical tools and applications that we can use to help slow down and hopefully even stop myopia from progressing. To check out those videos, I'll put them here to the side. Otherwise, please like this video if you learned something new and share with family and friends so we can together help spread this message of myopia and help stop it in its tracks. Thank you.